just want to start by smoothing the skin, smoothing it over with primer. It's beautiful, moisturizing primer. So good, smoothing out the complexion. It slides on like a film over your pores to retexturize the surface of your skin and bring out its optimum quality. To smooth it over the brow and down the temples, over the bridge of the nose, into the cheeks, outwards, and then round under the chin, round under the chin, and then all the way from the brow under the chin, like this. And then down the top of the neck. There we are. Smoothing it over. Creating the perfect canvas for the paint. So as I'm giving you this massage, the blood is coming to the surface of your skin, so it's bringing out that glow. That's really nice. That's really good. Yeah, it suits your skin. And it's just going to leave it looking nice and dewy, not oily, and certainly not dry, but just dewy look, dewy, juicy, plumped up skin. Perfect. Don't even really need any makeup now, but we will start getting on with it. There's often a lot of redness around the nose. That's one of the main places that lots of people forget to focus on. Because our eyes don't naturally focus down here, but somewhere our periphery vision can register those red patches, so to make sure we've stippled them. Smoothing it over as well when it starts to sort of dry and go tacky. Okay, just around there, just a little on the cheeks there. In. Okay, right over the top. I'm blending and we don't want any nice finish. Really, really nice finish. Yeah. Like that. Okay. Yeah, just shut those eyelids, please. And I'm just going to just lightly press on either one. A little bit of colour. Not much, but just a little over the top. Softly, but just making sure it's well blended. Yeah. Good. That's right. Yeah. And I will put some under the eyes as well. Let me just a bit more product. Okay. Yeah, you can keep the eyes closed. Just going to press and press. This fatter side of the sponge just to blot and get that really flawless finish so it's as natural as possible. So nice. Yeah, that just brings that illumination, you know. Really nice. Down here. Just above. Yeah. That's gorgeous. Really nice. Beams of light hitting your face and bouncing off. Refracting and reflecting over your skin. So nice. Use this to do a little bit more of a sort of highlight just around here in the inner corners on your Cupid's bow as well. Little makeup trick, yeah. Okay. You can open your eyes but keep very still and it won't go in your eyes and just underneath the gate. Just a little one. Just bring out the shape a little bit more. Okay, and I just want to bring even more bounce just to these little bits. so gently. Some brow mousse. Did you know that they make mousse for your brows? That will just tame any unruly brows. You've got really nice eyebrows, but this will just make sure that they're not too wild. Okay. It's kind of clear substance. Colour at all, but should I put a little bit of colour on them? No, I think I'll be fine actually. I think I'll just get on with the eyeliner, do a bit of eyeliner for you. And where should we do it? I think we'll just do like your outer corners here, just a bit here. Maybe go up in a little bit of a wing there, but not too much. Okay, shut your eyes. It's gonna look so good, it really suits you. Shimmery finish. Okay. eyelashes anyway. It just gives them a nice sort of coat. Of the lashes done smoothly up. Okay, on this side. Okay, wiggle the button. Cool. Really nice. That was cool. Silvery grey eyeshadow. It's really classy. Oh, that's a really nice colour on you. I like it. Yeah, that's great. Selling colour, and it's quite vibrant. It's got this kind of look at that. It's very orangey. You have to be quite brave to wear it, but you can definitely take it because you've got the confidence and you've got the character to be able to take it. So we can really go for it. Not many people can do eyes and lips, but you can get away with that. Yeah. Oh, I wish this colour suited me as well as it suits you. It looks really.